third module we are going to discuss now. It is the gear tooth measurement. As you can see over on the screen, we are going to discuss about the gear tooth measurement, another half module of the module 3. That is, this is the choice question. You can see over here, this is sixth question. Usually in the VT question paper, third module, sixth question we are discussing about now, right? In this gear tooth measurement, tooth thickness measurement with respect to different methods, right? These are different methods. Then this is another instrument which is going to be used, and different types of errors we're going to discuss with respect to the gear is concerned, right? In this particular module. So as you all know that one, gears, I think in the kinematics of machines, you have studied about the gears, right? Some the terminologies and the gears you have studied, and also numerical problem you have solved in this kinematics of machines, right? So some of the types of gear in that kinematics of machines also you have studied. So these are some of the gears. So basically, a gear is a mechanical element, as you know that one, right? The function of the gear is to transmit the motion as well as transmit the power. In order to transmit the motion or transmit the power, this mechanical element, it should possess the teeth on the periphery. That profile of the teeth will vary, and that name will going to be vary, right? Here, helical gear, spur gear, rack and pinion gear, worm gear, bevel gear, sprocket gear. So depending on the profiles of these gear tooth, they will be giving the different naming, and the functionality of the each gear also will going to differ from one application to other application. And basically, it is used to transmit the motion and power by engaging the tooths. Without engaging the tooth, it is not possible to transmit the motion and power. Only by engaging the tooth only or teeth only is possible to transmit, right? So before going into the topic, terminologies of the gear tooth, about the gear, right? So as I told, it is a mechanical element or a drive which transmits the power through these the teeth, right? Through the teeth. So usually it will be driver gear and the driven gear. Usually, what I see in the bicycles, the person only going to pedal by applying the force. That will be the driver one, right? And the sprocket, which is there at the back side for the back wheel, it will be the driven wheel, right? So driver will be always the bigger one. Driven will be the smaller one usually, right? The load will be taken by the driven one. Right, there is a smaller one where the effort has to be put onto the driver. So obviously the teeth will be more for the driver compared to the driven gears, right? Driver and driven. See, like these different types of gear, whether it can be spur gear, worm gear, helical gear, bevel gears, all these things basically it is used to transmit the power or transmit the motion, right? From one shaft to other shaft, or from one point to other point. In order to have this transmission of the power and the motion, accuracy is very much important. So in order to have that accuracy of transmitting the motion and power from one shaft to other shaft or one point to other point, these gear tooths or the gear blank has to be manufactured to that level of accuracy. If the gear itself won't be manufactured, you can't expect the gear to be transmit to that extent of the transmitting of the power and the motion from one shaft to other shaft. So it is important to manufacture the gear to the precise level as well as to inspect the gear to the precise level. Otherwise, that accuracy of the transmission will not be achieved, right? See, generally the gear you might have seen, this will be an example of the gearbox. In automotive, to shift the gears from first, second, third, like that, the gears, usually with the lever, we are going to change the gears. So the power input, the power output, that depends on the gear meshing with the other gears. It can be the spur gear, it can be the helical gear, it can be the bevel gear, depending on the applications, right? You can see that one example of that, the power input and the power output. Only by meshing, only when come in contact with the other, the tooth of one gear with the other tooth of the other gear, only with the meshing, it is possible to transmit the motion and the power. How well it transmit the motion, how well it transmit the power, that depends on the accuracy of the manufacturing. In order to know that accuracy of that manufacturing, you need to do the measurement. You need to do the measurement with the different measuring instruments. So those things and some of the errors we are going to discuss in this particular half module of the module 3, right? That is in the sixth question, actually the sixth question in the BTO question paper, what we are discussing. Here, the theoretical one is usually the transmission efficiency of the gears is usually 99%. The efficiency at which it transmits the power or the motion, it is usually 99%. That 99%, even though it may be the theoretical value, that 99%, it is possible only by manufacturing the component. So component means here what we're discussing is the gear, right? Not only manufacturing and also to test to that level of accuracy. Only then you can able to achieve the more efficiency of power transmission or motion transmission from one shaft to other shafts. See the right side of the image, what you are seeing here, this is the gear tooth terminologies. That means the special words which will be used, right? Terminologies. In the kinematics of machines also, you already studied this, right? I will brush up the things. Some of the terminologies we'll discuss this again in this particular one before going for the inspection or measurement of the these parameters of the gear which is being going to be used, right? Here, for proper inspection of the gears, it is important to concentrate on raw materials which is used for the manufacturing. That is the basic requirement. The material which is used to manufacture the gear plank need to be having the high quality. Otherwise, you can't able to expect the quality gear it toots, right? The heat treatment, the finishing of the teeth, the similarity of the tooths which is going to cut on the periphery of this gear plank, all these things will come into picture, right? See, in order to make the efficiency more and more for the transmission, the dimensional accuracy need to be inspected, it need to be tested. In that, one of the thing is tooth thickness, right? The tooth thickness is the one of the major element. With respect to that, we are going to discuss how to test the thickness of the tooth with the different methods, right, in the coming slides. See, this is the image which represent the terminologies of the gear tooth, right? Terminology means the standard words or the special words, denotions for the gear tooth, right? Usually, this is the example of the spur gear. The same image, I guess, it is being taken in the kinematics of machines also during the giving the discussion about the terminologies of the gear tooth, right? So I hope all of you seen this already, right? I'll explain one more time, right? See here, this is the face width, top land, again, this will be the addendum circle, right? So from this point to this point is addendum. So the dedendum from the pitch to the root, right? This is the working depth, hole depth, tooth thickness, which is measured from this point to this point. That is the flank which come in contact with the pitch circle, right? Tooth thickness. This is important. Based on this, we'll going to make the equations to be get, so that you can able to do the calculations to check to inspect the given gear blank tooth thickness, right? Not only tooth thickness with respect to the working depth also, right? This one is the pitch circle. Above it is the addendum circle. Below is the dedendum circle, right? Dedendum circle. This is bottom land. This is face. This is the clearance, right? From this to this, it will be the clearance. So those things one by one we will discuss now. So this is the image which is there in the textbook gear to terminology, right? And this is the one when during the meshing of the two gears, because gear is a mechanical element, it has to mesh with other gear in order to transmit the motion or the power from one shaft, from center of one shaft to center of the other shaft, in order to transmit the power. Right? This is the another image which represents the meshing of the two gears that come in contact. See, this will be the terminology we will discuss with respect to this image, the yellow color one, what you are seeing over here. This will take in another two or three slides. With respect to that, we are going to discuss the pitch circle. You can see over here the pitch circle, right? Pitch circle is here. This is the pitch circle, right? So it is an imaginary circle which by pure rolling action, that is the movement of this, will give the same motion as the actual gear. It is the pitch circle, the addendum, dedendum, the thickness of the tooth, all those parameters will be measured based on this pitch circle only, right? What you can see over here, the dotted line, this is the pitch circle, right? You can see over here, I marked in the red color. Again, pitch circle diameter, the overall diameter of this, right? It is the diameter of the pitch circle. The size of the gear is usually specified by the pitch circle diameter. If the gear blank which is used during the any of the operation to transmit the power or the motion, if it is having the gear diameter is 500 mm, 600 mm, those things, it represents based on this pitch circle only, right? It is also known as pitch diameter. It is also known as pitch diameter. Pitch point. In the third one, it is a common point of contact between two pitch circles. Two pitch circle here means when the gear blank mesh with the other gear, right? Here it is only one pitch circle is being shown. If you see the previous slide, see here, there is a pitch circle. You can observe here, there is a pitch circle, and one more here, it is the pitch circle, right? The meshing of these, this point is going to consider as the pitch point, right? It is common point of contact between two pitch circles of two meshing gear wheels. Pitch point, pressure angle, or it is also called angle of obliquity, pressure angle. You can observe the bottom image over here, pressure angle. It is an angle between a common normal to two gear teeth at a point of contact and common tangent at a pitch point. The standard pressure angles are represented like this, 4.5 and the 20 degree. These are the standard pressure angles with respect to this, with respect to the normal drawn, whatever the angle substituted, it is called pressure angle. You can observe here during the meshing also, this pressure angle will also the important element. Based on this angle only, you can able to make the better transmission of the power or the motion from one to other during the meshing. See, addendum is represented here, addendum, right? Addendum means, you can observe here, it is the radial distance of a tooth form from the pitch circle. This is the pitch circle to the top of the tooth or tip of the tooth. From this point to this point, pitch circle, it is considered as addendum. Similarly, dentum, here it is represented, the bottom one, dentum. It is the radial distance of the tooth from the pitch circle to the bottom of the tooth. You can observe here, this is the bottom of the tooth. This is dentum. Next, addendum circle. This is the image again I have taken so that you can able to see and observe, you can able to understand it. Addendum circle. You can see over here, addendum circle. It is shown here, right? Addendum circle. So it is a circle drawn through the top of the tooth. And it is a concentric with the pitch circle. As the pitch circle moves, similarly it is concentric with this one, right? These two, right? Pitch circle and this addendum circle. Similarly, dentum circle, you can observe here, dentum circle. There is one more name for the dentum circle, it is also called root circle. Dentum circle here. This is the dentum circle. So it is a circle drawn through the bottom of the tooth. This is the bottom, this is the topmost, this is the bottommost circle for the gear tooth. That is the root circle or dentum circle. Next parameter is the circular pitch. You can observe here, circular pitch. It is shown from this point to this point, circular pitch, right? So it is the distance measured on circumference of pitch circle. So this is a pitch circle. On the circumference of pitch circle, the distance will be measured. Circular pitch, right? But from what point to what point? From a point of one tooth to the corresponding point on the next tooth. From this point to this point, it is called circular pitch. In diametral pitch. The diametral pitch means it is the ratio of number of teeth to the pitch circle diameter. Number of teeth to the diameter of pitch circle. See here the equation diametral pitch, it is represented by T by D. So T will be number of teeth. In some books it is represented as Z. In some manuals, you're going to represent in terms of N. So all the different naming for the number of teeth, right? In 3LM lab also, while doing the inspection, while doing the experiment, you're going to come across these the standard words, right? That is the number of teeth, Z. In some books, it is represented N. And sometimes it is represented as T. So T represent the pitch circle diameter, this pitch circle diameter, which is used to mention the diameter of the gear itself, pitch circle diameter, right? So diametral pitch. So coming to the next one, module. So all of you know, module is the pitch circle diameter to the number of teeth. It is represented by small m. Usually it is represented by small m. Module is equal to D, right? That is the pitch circle diameter. In some textbook, it may have the different words for it, right? Different denotions, but the numerator is going to have the pitch circle diameter. That is the diameter of the gear blank itself divided by number of teeth that gear blank is going to possess. That is called module, which is represented by small m, right?
अमीना सर आपका
क्या टॉपिक
खोला आपने?
Right. See here, one question for it, for the model. In one of the MCQ, it is being given. You can see over here, a gear wheel has 36 teeth and 3 mm model. So what would be the pitch circle diameter? What would be the pitch circle diameter? What would be the answer for this? What would be the pitch circle diameter? Or the gear blank for this number of teeth and 3 mm model? What is the answer for this? Can anyone tell?
108 mm.
108, right. It is 108 mm. This is the answer. One of the MCQ is being asked because model is equal to D by T. Here it is asked about to calculate the D value, pitch diameter. Right, this one. So the teeth, it is given 36 into 3. That is the model 3. So 108 mm. So the next terminology of the gear, it is the clearance. So in order to understand this clearance, I have taken this image, the first image, what you are seeing here, right? This clearance, you can observe here, clearance, right? This is the one gear. Right, this is the other gear, driver and the driven. So whenever the gear meshes, so whatever the gap which will be left out, once it comes in contact and it's going to mesh, that gap is the clearance. See here, it is a radial distance from the top of the tooth to the bottom of the tooth. See, top of the tooth means top of the tooth of this gear, top of the tooth of this gear, and bottom of the tooth means from this one, driver driven. So a circle passing through the top of the meshing gear is known as clearance circle. So this is what the clearance, it is the distance between the top of the one tooth and the bottom of the another tooth. That gap will be considered as that clearance. See, now next the topic is total depth. Total depth here in this figure, see over here, this is represented over here, total depth. So it is the radial distance between addendum and addendum circles of the gear. Addendum circle is this one. Addendum circle is this. So this distance is represented as total depth of the tooth, which is equal to the sum of addendum and addendum. Addendum plus addendum, you're going to get the total depth of the given gear tooth. So next is face of the tooth. Face of the tooth, you can observe here, this is the face, tooth face, right? It is the surface of the gear tooth above the pitch surface. This is the pitch surface here above it. So the safe, the face, what it is built there on the above the pitch surface is called as face of the tooth, right? Again, flank of the tooth, you can observe here, flank of the tooth, this is the flank. It is the surface of the gear tooth below the pitch surface. So this will be the pitch surface above the, which come in contact with the pitch circle. Above it, it is the face, below it, it is the flank. Again, the next topic is top gland. It is the surface of the top of the tooth. This will be called as top gland, right? Face width, you can observe here. This is the face width. So it is the width of the gear tooth measured parallel to its axis. Face width. Then again, profile. It is the curve formed by face. So this is the face, and whatever the profile, what is the curve, what it going to form, right? You can observe over here on the screen, the red curve marking, this is the profile, right? It is the curve formed by the face and flank of the tooth. This is called profile. So this is profile of the gear. Based on this, you can able to justify or judge which type of gear blank it is actually. That is called profile. It is the curve, the form of it, right? In some books, the terminology of the gear tooth here is going to represent in this pattern also. So all the terminologies it is going to represent here also, right? See clearance from this point to this point. It is the clearance circle from top to the bottom of the other gear tooth. So this is the machine of two gears, the driver and the driven one. You can able to observe here the clearance value. So from this to this clearance. So these things are already studied, right? Again, another one, the profile. I think this also is studied in the kinematics of machine, the profile of the gear tooth, right? So usually while manufacturing the gear tooth, these are the commonly used profiles. So profile I discussed just now, right? Profile means it is the curve formed by the face and the flank of the tooth, the profile, right? Profile. Usually while manufacturing the gear tooth, they're going to decide which type of profile it need to be manufactured. The two common profiles are these two, involute. Another one is cycloidal, right? So usually the gear tooth will be manufactured on the milling machines, right? So we'll discuss about this involute tooth profile. We can observe the profile of this gear is different from this gear, right? In between these two, which one will tend to wear out more? Because of the friction while coming in contact with the other gear blank, which one usually going to tend to wear out more? This one will tend to more wear out, right? We'll discuss that now. See here, cycloidal gear tooth is this side, what you are seeing, the right side, and the left side is the involute one, right? So involute, again, cycloidal. Generally, these are the two interference. In involute gear tooth profile, interference is there. Here, there is no interference. Interference means you can observe over here. In this, interference is at this point where the gear and the pinion will go to mesh interference. But that will not be there in this cycloidal tooth profile. The more wear and tear as contact takes place, more wear and tear for this involute gear tooth profile because it is the convex surface. You can observe this animation here in the left side about this involute tooth profile, how much closely it's going to come in contact as compared to the cycloidal tooth profile at this point. So obviously this is having more wear and tear. This is less wear and tear as it is having the concave flanks, right? So usually even though it is having the more wear and tear, even though it is having the interference, even though the teeth it will be the weaker one, but still this involute tooth profile gears will be used more in the engineering components compared to the cycloidal tooth profile. So this is the most common one, involute tooth profile compared to the cycloidal tooth profiles, right? See, next about the measurement of individual elements of the gear, right? Measurement of individual elements of the gear. So this is about the accuracy, right? So talked about how accurately the component, the gears will can able to transmit the power or the motion from one shaft to other shaft or from one point to other point. That depends on the manufacturing of the gears and once it has been manufactured, in order to confirm that the components is being manufactured, because usually if you see this in the screen, the gear, it is having multiple teeth, right? Gear all should having the similarly the same thickness of the tooth, right? All having the same profile, the face, the flank, those things, right? Whether the component, because it is also a component, even though it is used to transmit the power and motion, but it is need to be fabricated. Once it is being fabricated, it need to be inspected. So in order to do that inspection measurement, so one of the parameter which is more important is the thickness of the tooth. So in order to measure the tooth thickness, there are various methods will be there, right? That we are going to discuss now, how to measure the gear tooth thickness of the given gear plank. See here, measurement of tooth thickness. The tooth thickness means it is defined as the length of the arc, because it is not possible to measure directly. It is the length of the arc, tooth thickness. If this is the tooth, from this point is the thickness of the tooth, right? From this point to this point, it will be the thickness of the tooth that need to be measured. So usually the thickness of the tooth is generally measured at the pitch circle. You can see the red lines here, I represented pitch circle. So this is the pitch circle for this gear, and for the pinion, this is the pitch circle. The red lines markings pitch circle for this and for this. Either maybe for the pinion or for the gear, the thickness of the tooth will be measured at the pitch circle. So the methods which is used for measuring the thickness of the tooth, right? These are some of the methods. You can see over here various methods for measuring the thickness of the tooth. In that, the first one is caudal thickness method. That is measurement of tooth thickness by using gear tooth vernier caliper. So all of you seen and all of you use the vernier caliper, right? But here it is gear tooth vernier caliper. Using this instrument, they can able to check the thickness of the tooth. Right? It is also called caudal thickness method. This is important one in the exam. Usually you're going to ask. This is the sixth question. If you have seen in the VT question paper, the eighth question paper which I have sent to you, you can see that multiple times this question is being asked for the measurement of the tooth thickness by using gear tooth vernier caliper or caudal thickness method. The second one is constant chord method. This is another method. The third one is base tangent method. The fourth is measurement of dimensions over pins. These are the four different methods of measuring the tooth thickness, right? So we'll discuss one by one, and you can see over here the arrow mark. Only these first three methods we will going to discuss as per it is concerned. The first one is the caudal thickness method. The second one is constant chord method. The third one is the base tangent method with respect to the pitch circle. One by one we will going to discuss. The first one, what you are seeing on the screen, is the first method of measuring the thickness of the tooth, right? Gear tooth vernier caliper method. You can observe the image over here. This is the instrument. And in the Trivalum lab, for you, you're going to have the experiment. You're going to have this experiment. Each individual student has to perform this experiment, right? This instrument, it is there in the Trivalum lab. You have to use it individually. You have to measure this gear tooth thickness. It is called gear tooth vernier caliper. It is like the normal vernier caliper. You're going to have the measurement of only the length, or you can call it as the width. But here, in this case, you can able to measure the depth also, right? The tooth depth is also possible. See here, you can observe this image. the gear to the vernier caliper instrument. Here also one scale is there, here also one scale, horizontal as well as vertical, right? Both it is having the scale. You can able to move this measuring face this side also as well as at the top position also, right? If you move this, you can able to measure the thickness. You can observe here, this is the pitch circle. The thickness of the gear tooth will be measured at this pitch circle, gear tooth thickness, because this is the entire tooth. We can make this vernier caliper to measure at this position also, at this position also. But in order to get to know the thickness of the gear tooth, the better way is to measure the gear tooth thickness only at the pitch circle, only at this point, what you are seeing on the screen, right? Pitch circle. That's why here it has been shown only to this height of the teeth, the thickness of the tooth will be measuring. So not only this, by using the horizontal vernier scale, right? Caudal thickness. Caud means from this point to this point. That's what is called caudal thickness method. The thickness, or you can call it as the width, W. As well as the vertical vernier scale. See, this is horizontal one. One more is there, vertical here. Right? This vertical vernier scale gives the caudal radiandum. This distance, thickness as well as this depth, both can be measured at a time using this gear tooth vernier caliper measuring instrument. This is represented by W, this is represented by D, the depth, thickness or the width, caudal thickness method, right? So it is measured at the pitch line. The Tribhulam lab also is going to do this experiment. Gear tooth vernier caliper method to measure the gear tooth thickness. So this is how the positioning of the gear tooth vernier caliper on the gear tooth. You can observe here, there are two scales here also, right? Here also, with respect to the pitch circle, this is the thickness. You can see it is being represented by W. This is the chord, right? Caudal thickness. See here, gear tooth vernier caliper has two vernier scale and they are set for the width W of the tooth and depth from the top at which W occurs. These two parameters can be measured using this gear tooth vernier caliper, W and D. Right. This image I'm going to take in the next slide again. The caudal thickness. This method is also called as caudal thickness method. Caudal thickness or tooth thickness is what this you can observe here on the screen. Right? Caudal thickness, which is represented by W here in the previous image. Caudal addendum means D, right? From the top to the pitch, right? See here, now comes the derivation, a small derivation to get into the equations for these two parameters. One is W, other one is the D. This is caudal thickness, this is caudal radiandum, right? W and D. Even though the gear is going to have multiple teeth, like you see over here, multiple teeth, by using gear tooth vernier caliper here, only on one tooth, only on any tooth, they are going to do this measurement, right? But in the lab, for the purpose of doing the measurement, you can able to do for the one or two teeth on the alternatively in any positions. But usually, it will be done only on the single tooth. to measure the W and D, right? That is width and the depth, caudal thickness, caudal addendum. The W and D value, what you are seeing, this thickness as well as this depth, caudal addendum, it can able to do the measurement only on one tooth at a time, not on the multiple tooth. You can do, you can take the trials on more than one or two teeth, then you can able to sum up, but only on one tooth it can able to do the measurement at a time using the gear tooth vernier caliper, right? See, consider only one gear tooth, as you can see here in the image. See here, W is the chord, A, D, B. You can observe here, A, D, B. This is the chord, caudal thickness, right? Which is represented by W, width, right? But the tooth thickness is specified as a arc distance, A, E, B. So also the depth, D, is another parameter, right? Adjusted on the instrument is slightly greater than the addendum CE, right? So width W is therefore called as caudal thickness. This is caudal thickness, caudal addendum, right? See, W is equal to this width or the thickness is equal to AB. As per this is concerned, this is like a small derivation to get into the equation with respect to W and D. W is equal to AB, which equal to 2 times AD. This AB, you can able to write in terms of 2 times the AD. So AD is half of it. 2 times the AD will be the distance A to B, which is equal to the width of this particular gear tooth measured at the pitch circle, right? Caudal thickness. And also you know that one, for the gears, the value of theta equal to 360 by 4n, where n is the number of teeth cut on the periphery of the given gear blank. See now, the first equation with respect to W, right? Like I told, the width, the thickness of it. See over here, the same figure I have taken in the next slide also here, right? This is one gear tooth, because at a time, you can able to measure on the only on the one gear tooth, the thickness. With respect to this W, you are getting the equation now. See, consider a triangle ADO, right? The triangle ADO. You can observe here on this image, ADO, right? For the reference purpose, I have taken this triangle over here. You can observe here the cursor, ADO. This is the theta angle suspended, right? See now, W is equal to 2AD, right? As you can see over here, W is equal to 2AD. That means W is this one, the thickness is equal to AB. That AB can be written in terms of 2 times the AD, right? So that's what W is equal to 2AD, 2 times the AD value. See this AD now, here, in order to get this value of this AD, the triangle has been considered ADO. Here we can observe. From this triangle ADO, sine theta, trigonometry function of sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. With respect to this as the theta angle subtended, so this side will be the opposite AD, right? All of you know now, trigonometry function sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. With respect to this angle theta, the opposite is opposite, right? That is AD. So opposite by hypotenuse, AD by AO, AD by AO, right? Now here, in order to get the equation for the AD, in order to substitution AD value, so you can write this AD is equal to AO into sine theta, right? Now AO, you can observe over here, AO or OA is nothing but the radius, right? Radius of the pitch circle. You can observe on the image, OA is the radius of the pitch circle. That's what. So OA or AO is represented in terms of R value, radius of the pitch circle. So 2 into, instead of AO, they have written as R sine theta. The theta value is 360 by 4N, right? Because it is the gear. So value of theta is 360 by 4N. That is substituted here. 2R sine 360 by 4N. And also you know that one, module M is equal to diameter of the pitch circle divided by number of teeth. So in the gear to terminology we discuss, it is D by T, right? There is pitch circle diameter divided by number of teeth. In that, I told the number of teeth, it can be in terms represented as capital T or Z or N, right? So now here you can see it has been represented by N. Number of teeth, it can be represented in terms of N also, T also, or Z also, right? So module is pitch circle diameter by number of teeth. So pitch circle diameter means, so pitch circle radius, if it is R, so pitch circle diameter will be 2 times the radius, 2R by N. So for this, we take in terms of R value, because you have to substitute here in terms of R. Further, if you go to substitute it, R is equal to N into M divided by 2. So W, finally, this equation, W, there is a thickness, the caudal thickness will become W is equal to 2 times AD. See, AD value is nothing but this AO sine theta, right? So AO is R, that R value here, NM by 2, that is being substituted here into sine theta, sine 360 by 4N. So finally, we're going to get this equation, W is equal to NM sine 90 by N. So N represent number of teeth for the given gear blank, and M represent module. So once that number of teeth is being known, as well as the circle diameter is known, we can able to calculate the thickness of the given gear tooth only for one gear at a time using the gear tooth vernier caliper. What we are discussing is theoretical way of measuring the thickness of the gear tooth. You can compare this with practically, right? You can able to do it practically also. So this is theoretical way of getting the value for gear tooth thickness or caudal thickness, which is measured at the pitch circle, W value. One more parameter is there, D. With respect to D, how to get the equation, we'll discuss in the next slide now. See now, with respect to D, you can see the equation. With respect to D, it is being represented, caudal triandum. See here, the same image is being taken over here. Again, in order to get this equation with respect to D, right, you can able to see over here, D, you can able to write the D in terms of OC minus OD. This D distance, it is obtained by OC minus OD. You can able to write in terms of this D value. See, all of you know that one, the addendum is a radial distance from the pitch circle, right? All of you know that one, addendum means the radial distance from the pitch circle to the tip. This is the tip of the tooth, right? From the tip of the tooth, you can see the cursor, from the tip of the tooth to the pitch circle, it is considered as addendum. Below this, it is addendum, right? And its value equal to 1 module, right? See here, OC, because you have to substitute over here in order to get the equation for small d, OC, OD, you have to get the equations. Now with respect to OC, it is from O to C, this one. See, OC now, it can be written in terms of OE plus addendum. OC can be written in terms of OE plus addendum, because from this point, pitch circle to tip, it is considered as addendum, right? OE. OE is what? NM by 2. How we got this NM by 2? See the previously one. NM by 2, it is the value of this R, right? NM by 2. Here, OE. Value of R. You can observe here on the screen, OE. It is the, can, this is the arc, right? A pitch circle. The radius of the pitch circle R, right? OE. This value of R, what you obtained in the previous one, that it is being substituted here, right? NM by 2. You can see here, NM by 2, the value of R here, right? Observe. See now, OE plus addendum, that is R plus M. OE is R plus M. So, addendum is equal to 1 module, which is represented here, R plus M. So, NM by 2 plus M, which is module. So now, once you get the equation to the OC, one more you have to get the with respect to OD. So OD, where it is here from O, this is D, this point, OD. That OD, again, you have to consider the triangle for it. The same triangle, now again, you considered it ADO. You can observe here, from the triangle ADO, now cos theta. Cos theta is adjacent by hypotenuse. This is the angle subtended. So this is OD by OA. This you can able to write in terms of OD. So OD is equal to cos theta into R. Directly written R, because R is nothing but OA. You can observe here in the image. Radius of this pitch circle OA, right? So OD is equal to R into cos theta. That is taken here directly. Right. If you get confused, you can able to see over here. This is a triangle which has been considered. From that, they got this equation. OD is equal to R cos theta. You can observe here, right? Now, the value of R, it is NM by 2. Right? From the previous one, NM by 2. Cos theta. So, theta here, the separate one, 90 by N. So, again, D is equal to finally this equation OC OD substituted. So finally we're going to get this equation. So this is the caudal dedendum. This is the another parameter which you can able to measure using gear tooth vernier caliper W as well as D. So NM by 2 into 1 plus 2 by N minus cos 90 by N. So this is the another equation with respect to the thickness of the gear tooth using gear tooth vernier caliper is concerned. So this is important in the VTO question paper. If you see it, most of the time it is going to ask, right? Usually in the 8 question papers, I think around 3 to 4 times it is being asked for this. So you get the equation or to measure the thickness of the gear tooth by using gear tooth vernier caliper. Get the equation. One is with respect to W. Otherwise, with respect to D. Right? This is the first method of measuring the gear tooth thickness by using gear tooth vernier caliper. It is also called caudal thickness method. The least count of this gear tooth vernier caliper, it is again how much?